What's up, everybody? Welcome back to Exotic Astrology again. And today we will continue with our Bhagavad Gita discussion. We completed the first 9 verses of the first chapter of the Gita, and today we will begin with the 10th verse, and we will see further ahead what is there in the verses. Till now, Duryodhana has gone to Dronacharya, his teacher, and started discussing about the strengths of his opponents and his own strengths. And now he is going to describe in detail about the different warriors that are present on his side. And he has already discussed the personalities, and now he's going to elaborately describe the strength of the size of the army, etc. That's kind of an over exaggeration which he will do. We will see that. And we know the technique which Duryodhana is using in these verses. He's trying to extrapolate his own strength, and he's trying to denigrate the strength of his enemies. That's how is an expert politician. He knows how to seem the other world or the other party not very significant and try to prove that his own subjects are very strong and invincible. Now, if we start with the 10th verse, let's begin with the prayer. Om Agyan Timirandhasya Gyanan Jana Shalakaya Chakshurun Militam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. And yes, if you are new to the channel, then subscribe to it and like this video if you like this video. So the 10th verse of the Gita, the first chapter, is as follows. Aparyaptam tat asmakam balam bhishma bhirakshitam paryaptam toidam itesham balam bhima bhirakshitam. First word is bhishma abhirakshitam, and the second is bhima abhirakshitam. Do not confuse in this. The first translation goes like this: our strength is immeasurable and we are perfectly protected by grandfather Bhishma. Whereas the strength of the Pandavas, carefully protected by Bhima, is limited. That's what he's trying to do. He's trying to compare Bhishma with Bhima. See what a foolish comparison this is. How can there be any comparison between Bhishma and Bhima? But he is trying to show here, he is portraying his obsession towards Bhima. Duryodhana was always obsessed about defeating Bhima, about conquering him, about humiliating him. That is why whenever he used to talk of the Pandavas, he always used to refer to by saying them Bhima's side, Bhima's party, which means he was so obsessed about him. You can know about a person by seeing his obsessions, right? You can know what he values or what he dislikes by seeing what he is obsessed about. For example, in this, if you read the purport, it is explained here. Herein, an estimation of comparative strength is made by Duryodhana. He thinks that the strength of his armed forces is immeasurable. Being specifically protected by the most experienced general, grandfather Bhishma, which there is no doubt, Bhishma is the commander-in-chief of the army, his grandfather. On the other hand, the forces of the Pandavas are limited. Being protected by a less experienced general, Bhima. Bhima was his cousin, as we know, who is like a fig in presence of Bhishma. So it's written here, Bhima, who is his cousin, is like a fig in the presence of Bhishma, which is very obvious, I mean. Duryodhana was always envious of Bhima because, hear this carefully, Duryodhana was always envious of Bhima because he knew perfectly well, that if at all he should die, he would only be killed by Bhima. Should I repeat? Because he knew perfectly well that if he should die at all, he would only be killed by Bhima. Because Bhima had taken a vow in the assembly where Draupadi was disrobed that I will kill all the 100 Kurus. But at the same time, he was confident of his victory on the account of the presence of Bhishma, who was a far superior general. His conclusion that he would come out of the battlefield victorious was well ascertained. So, although he knew that Pandavas are very powerful, Krishna is also there on their side. But he was very confident that no, the ultimate victory, the end result will be mine. I will take the cake. I will have the last laugh because Bhishma is there on my side. Bhishma is extremely powerful. He even defeated Parshuram also. Parshuram is the one who had wiped out the kings, the Kshatriyas, 21 times from the earth when the Kshatriyas became very egoistic and very arrogant and they started doing irreligious activities. Then Parshuram, being a Brahman, the son of the great Jamadagni and Renuka, he is one of the avatars of Vishnu, incarnations of Lord Vishnu himself. And then Parshuram came and slaughtered the entire race of the kings, the Kshatriyas. And he did it not once, twice, thrice, he did it 21 times. And then at the end he came and washed his hands in the Kurukshetra. That is why that place is very auspicious. And he dropped his weapons in and he started meditation. And then Parshuram goes to the Mahendra Parvat and he does penance there. And Bhishma had once, due to some reason, he had to fight with Parshuram. Parshuram was his guru. He had learnt from Parshuram about the war and about religion, about spirituality, about everything. And then due to some reason, he had to fight with Parshuram and then Parshuram was defeated by Bhishma. They fought for 21 days and ultimately Bhishma almost defeated Parshuram and then due to somehow the battle was called off. But the point here is Bhishma is invincible. He has been known for conquering everybody. So Duryodhana is very confident that even if Bhima is there on their side, it doesn't matter because Bhishma Pitamaha is there on my side. He's very confident. That's what is written here. His conclusion that he would come out of the battle victorious was well ascertained. Alright, so Duryodhana is very confident that because of Bhishma's presence, he will win the war of Kurukshetra. Now let us see what does he have to say ahead. Now what Duryodhana is doing in the 11th verse. In the 11th verse, he goes and tells the other personalities, the other warriors in the battlefield that you should now support Bhishma, our grandfather. And he says it like this. Anyaneshu cha sarvesho yatha bhagam avasthita bhishmam eva bhirakshantu bhavantaha sarva eva hi. All of you must now give full protection to grandfather Bhishma as you stand at your respective strategic points of entrance into the phalanx of the army. All of you must now give full support to Bhishma, not support, full support to grandfather Bhishma as you are standing at the respective strategic positions of entrance into the phalanx of the army. So the army was stationed in a way that was known as Vyuha. Vyuha means a formation of the army where in every front there would be a particular general who would be staying and protecting the enemy's entrance into the formation. There are different kinds of formations, like there was Garud view, there was Conch view and so many others. We will see them later, but now here it is mentioned that all of them were positioned at strategic points. So he is telling them from there you have to support the grandfather Bhishma because his protection is of paramount importance for our victory. That's what he is trying to ascertain here. The purport to the 11th verse is as follows. Duryodhana, after praising the prowess of Bhishma, further considered that others might think that they have been considered as less important. Just see. So, in his usual diplomatic way, he tried to adjust the situation in the above words. So, now Bhishma, he glorifies Bhishma and then he's a bit concerned. What if others think that we are not valuing them, like Dronacharya or Shalya or Kripa? So I should try to acknowledge their position also. See how clever he is. He emphasized that Bhishma Dev was undoubtedly the greatest hero, but he was an old man. Yes, Bhishma was very old. So everyone must especially think of his protection from all sides. Everybody tried to protect him. Bang on. He might become engaged in the fight and the enemy might take advantage of this full engagement on one side. That is true. Therefore, it was important that other heroes not leave their strategic positions and allow the enemy to break the flanks. So the army phalanx was arranged in a way to protect Bhishma and Duryodhana because they were the main heroes. So their main agenda was not to let anybody enter inside so that they can attack Bhishma or Duryodhana. Duryodhana clearly felt that the victory of the Kurus depend on the presence of Bhishma Dev. There is no doubt about it. He was confident of the full support of Bhishma Dev and Dronacharya in the battle because he knew very well that they did not even speak a word when Arjuna's wife Draupadi, in her helpless condition, had appealed to them for justice while she was being forced to appear naked in the presence of all the great generals in the assembly. That's very unfortunate. Although he knew that the two generals had some sort of affection for the Pandavas, he hoped that these generals would now completely give it up as they had done during the gambling performance. So what has happened? What happened was the Pandavas were invited for a gambling match by Duryodhana. And then they cheated them. The Kurus cheated the Pandavas. And then later on, they lost everything, the Pandavas. And Draupadi was the wife of the Pandavas. And then she was being summoned in the assembly. And Duryodhana tried to strip her naked. And then finally, Lord Krishna protected her dignity and her chastity by giving her unlimited sari. Sari or cloth, whatever you want to call it. So then what happened is, Duryodhana speaks about this here. That they did not speak a word. Who? They means Bhishma and Drona. They did not speak a word when Draupadi was being insulted. Now why they didn't speak? Because that was wrong. That was a mistake they did. They should have spoken. They should have protested. But on a technical sense, why they didn't speak was because they thought, okay, the king is not speaking anything. What can we speak? But that doesn't justify their actions. Because of this, Krishna will punish them, both Drona and Bhishma. They will be killed. Krishna doesn't spare anybody who insults his devotees. That is it. And we will continue the next verses later. So, what did we see here? That Duryodhana is emphasizing on protecting Bhishma and how he is confident on Bhishma's power and his prowess and in the fact that the mere presence of Bhishma alone is sufficient to grant him victory because of Bhishma's unlimited prowess. Alright, that is it from my side. If you're new to the channel, then subscribe to it. And if you like this video, click the thumbs up and share it with others and discuss it with your family and your friends. Until next time, wish you good luck. Bye-bye. See you.